No, we're at the top where we're going to present the Lifetime Achievement Awards. Our first presenter is B.B. Miller. As we all know, B.B. is a native of New York and currently lives in Columbus, Ohio, where she is a distinguished professor at Ohio State University. She formed the B.B. Miller Company in 1985, and her choreography has been produced in major dance centers across the country and throughout the world. She is a Guggenheim Fellow and a four-time BESSY Award winner. Please welcome B.B. Miller.
Hi, everybody. It's my great honor to introduce Murray Lewis for the Martha Hill Award. I saw him earlier today, and I told him I'd be here, and he says hi. Anyway, I thought I'd start off with some stuff that I didn't know about Murray. He was born in Brooklyn. He was born in Brooklyn in November 1926. He was raised on the Lower East Side of Manhattan. He was one of five kids. His mother died when he was eight. His older sister, Ethel, took him to modern dance classes, concerts around the city. He was in the Navy up until 1946. Then settled in San Francisco. He studied with Hanya Hall, which I didn't know, at Colorado College, and met Nick there in about 1946, I believe, 47, and 48? Okay, yeah, the gospel is right here. So, okay, and by 1949, they were back in New York. Colorado College is where they met. Through the GI Bill. From Ruth Broward, you know, gospel, right there. Who was my first dance teacher right there. By 1949, they were back in New York, and he was the lead soloist for the Playhouse Dance Company. And he was Nick's associate director in 1951. And soon after that, that's when I come in. So Henry Street Settlement was really a great home for city kids. It was a place to learn the arts from artists, a place to absorb a way of looking at the world that was magical, endlessly creative, and deeply fun. Thanks to my mother, who took the adult classes, we showed up every Saturday for dance class, and then a quick stop at the Essex Street Market, if maybe some of you remember that, for a chicken that was hanging by its neck, before heading home to Red Hook, the old Red Hook, not before IKEA. And I didn't know how lucky I was to have a Henry Street Settlement in my life, because at 4 years old or so, you just don't think of what luck is, you just show up. But I did know that my teacher, Murray Lewis, was the best reason to get out of bed on a Saturday. He was wonderful. He was funny, he was strict, he was dynamic, his arms stretched like this. He sat us up on his shoulder, and he loved us. He loved us all. He charmed me into a life of dancing and making dances, improvising dances about trees, clouds, empty chocolate boxes, I remember that one, lines, about anything. Murray made me see the space, the alive space around me. And he taught me how to share it with anyone who was interested enough to look. Years later, we would meet up now and again. I was an official choreographer with a company. We met in LA. We were both on tour with our companies. But I still felt that I was one of his special, kind of the little kid who did good. And I think he was proud of me, which I really appreciated. I think of him often when I'm choreographing and when I'm teaching. And I wish I could handle a beat the way that he could, with his foot on the drum, you remember those? And two drumsticks, and he was keeping the beat as we crossed the floor, which was, the crossing the floor was really the best part of class, not the stretching. Just going across the floor. And since I learned how to shape energy and space and time from Murray, I know that he is embedded in every gesture that I make. He's part of every choice, if it's this or this. And so his way of perching up, his remarkable hands, his pizzazz and his sly grace has been seeded through me and passed on not only through me, but to even more hundreds and thousands of all of our students and our audiences and our dance partners from and through so many of us who are sitting in this room right now. From Murray, I learned that dancing is a way of making sense of the world. And the world has shifted, certainly, and we're living lives that we probably hadn't anticipated on so many levels. But we still live in our senses, in our awareness of each other, and the light and shadow and motion that we create. Murray's choreography has been all over the world. We know that. He's made over 100 works. He's received awards. He's pretty fabulous. And as of today, he still tells a pretty good joke. So I want to thank you, the Martha Hill Fund and Board of Directors, for honoring Murray, because there are thousands of us who are moving through the world and noticing every detail, shimmering with the light, standing tall and deep and wide, thanks to him. Thank you, Murray.
Good evening. My name is Alberto Del Saz. After working for many years as the rehearsal director and a principal dancer of the Nikolai Lewis Dance Company, I now serve as the artistic director of the Nikolai Lewis Foundation for Dance. Nick and Murray's artistic legacy have been a major force in my life for over 30 years. Every one of my days involves Murray in one way or another. Today, Bibi and I had a lovely time with Murray at his home here in the city. Fully animated and true to form, Murray delighted in telling jokes and stories. We all had a few laughs about the good old days. Murray recently celebrated his 89th birthday. Even though his mind skips from one topic to another, dance is a common thread that continues to be a vivid and important part of his life. Murray continues to choreograph in his mind and remains immersed in music and sound. He crafts every one of his steps, from his big comfortable chair to his bed, from the kitchen table to the TV room, and with the thoughtfulness and detail that only he could do. Once in a while, he accompanies himself by singing an old Broadway tune. One of his biggest secrets was that he always wanted to be a big Broadway star. Murray and I often share thoughts and anecdotes about his long career as a dancer, choreographer, educator, and mentor. And while he does not visit with us as much as he would like, he truly knows how loved he is by all of us and by his dancing family. Many of us know how much Murray enjoys a good party, especially if it is if it was celebrating him and his dancing. He sends his deepest apology and regrets not being able to accept this prestigious award in person. Murray asked me to thank the Martha Hill Dance Fund and its board of directors, a special thanks to B.B. Miller, Vernon Scott, and also to thank each and every one of you that brought joy to his life. I'm honored to accept this award on Murray's behalf. I couldn't think of a better way to say thank you to all of you than with a few minutes of Murray's glorious dancing. On behalf of Murray, the Nicola Lewis Foundation for Dance, and myself, thank you for recognizing Murray's tremendous gifts to our profession. Thank you.
Lewis is a unique American artist. He has danced on five continents, and the world has shared his artistry. He is first and foremost an articulator of emotional expression, and it is this clarity of motion which has made his art so universally accessible. From the quietly poetic to the most physically complex movement, his extraordinary range has always been evident.
Although I had made my debut in 1953, it wasn't until the journal, created 4 years later, that I felt I had arrived as an artist. I remember walking from the stage after one performance, thinking I would never again be afraid of the stage, thinking I was at last in command of myself, thinking it took me 31 years to reach this point. Journal had a simple theme, a theme which every creative artist undertakes at least once in his or her career. It was, in a sense, autobiographical. It traced the path from first awakening to self-discovery, to love-sick youth, to physical exuberance, to psychological intrusions, and finally, to the sagacity of age. With Journal, I had discovered life. With Hoopla, created 15 years later, I had matured enough to make fun of it. Over the years, Hoopla and Deja Vu became two of my audience favorites.
great to see those beautiful movements by Murray. I had the great pleasure of having him create a ballet on me in 1985, and boy, was that a treat. I just said, Murray, I can't do it. And he said, well, just copy me and you'll do it. I said, fine, do it again. So I just copied him. And I went on stage and I had the greatest time because I could mirror, I could see his image in front of me in all that black. And it was very easy after that. But you've got to know Murray Lewis, and he just laughed his way through the whole thing. He choreographed it in 1 hour and gave me a hug and left the studio. And I was on stage the next night. That was the art of Murray Lewis. He's a spectacular man.